Greetings all. My name is Chuck Foster. I'm employed with the Utah State Office of Education as the American Indian Education Specialist. And I also like to introduce myself in Navajo. Chuck Foster and Shiel. Ki ani shleon tsetslan ni bashish chin. Do hanagani shenel do tapash chik without the nin shleon. Fort Defiance tell so that I need an asha. The base of this preparation for these students is to have these kids fit within the society which they are part of. I think a lot of these kids oftentimes they feel left out. And I think one of the largest areas that we have with this camp is to instill that they belong in the society and they have a lot of contributions. Their ancestor had a lot of contributions. And that's one area. And the other part is that when they leave this camp, you know, sometimes it's difficult because they're going back into a culture. They're going back into a society where they're straddling two worlds, two cultures, two of everything in terms of how they live. And hopefully to have these kids to adjust to those lifestyles.
I have thought about kids not actually bringing our tradition and keeping it up and alive, because technology is like going overboard and they're really relying on that instead of bringing the spiritual part in you, what your elders taught, because soon they'll be gone and the things you want to know when you're older are going to die out too.
I think it's really important to connect back with what our ancestors used to do and to like keep the heritage and the tradition that we used to have and make it like live on so then it doesn't die out.
It's just something that we grew up with, like, and what our parents taught us, and it's what they grew up with too. Just knowing that it's going to be passed down and it's going to stay for a long time if we keep it going.
The camp is an open invitation to all the students. The open invitation includes their mind, body, and spirit coming here and leaving that open in terms of what they can learn. And I think that as they open up their hearts, mind, body, and soul, we feel that the curriculum that we have prepared for them will instill of the identity, will instill their culture, will instill some of the academic areas in which they're pursuing in schools today.
It's a way to keep Native children grounded. Not wrestling with two cultures and trying to understand an identity of who they are, but recognize that they can be parallel and really even be beneficial if they take the best of both worlds, but always keep their cultural identity, that base of who they are and where they came from.
So having this camp is just a wonderful opportunity for these youth to be able to come, participate, and learn about their culture and be able to pick up on what is available as well as future careers that they could have in managing public land resources.